Welcome back. We have done now some basic stuff in Excel VBA. So when you start creating a project in VBA, the first thing you need to do is create a new workbook. So let's see how we can create a new workbook and save it using a macro. We'll go to Tools, Macro, Visual Basic Editor. We need a Visual Basic Editor to write our macro, isn't it? Insert, Module. Module is inserted. Now we will write the macro name, starting with subroutine. So add new, that's the macro name. Then we will say set new book. This is the syntax of VBA, okay? So work books. The moment you write dot, nothing happens because I made a mistake. It is work boost, so I have to write work books. And then when I put the dot, you see I get options. What do I want to do? I want to close, I want to do something else. So many options are there, but we want to add. So we'll click on this and press tab from the keyboard. And now, with this new workbook selected, actually with new book, we are now going to assign some properties to this new book. So it should have the title dot, and title dot will refer to this new book, and that will have a title called employee details. Then the subject, so dot subject will be equal to employees, or will be assigned the value employees. Whatever is on the right hand side of this equation is assigned to the value on the left hand side. So title assigned the value employee details, subject is assigned the value employees. And now we will also save this by putting a dot save as file name. Colon equals, now we will save this file as employee details dot xls. So we provide even the extension of the file name. And then because we started this code with width, we are going to say end width. Alright, now when I run this macro, add new, or the module one here by clicking on this play button, or I can press F5 from the keyboard, let's see what happens. So I'll just click on this and we get a new window and it asks us, what do you want to do? So we will say, okay, run this macro, add new. And something happens. Did you notice that? So I'm going to minimize this. A new workbook has been created with the name employee details. That is what we wanted, isn't it? Then we'll go to file, go to properties. So properties is right here. And we'll first go to general. So you see, this is the file I saved using a macro. This is saved in the My Documents because that is the place we have assigned Excel to save its files, the default place, which is My Documents. And you can see here it has been given a DOS name by truncating it to 8 characters. The date of creation, the date of modification, and the last access date is also given here. Let's go to summary. And you see title, employee details, subject, employees. This is the author and this is the company's name. This is exactly what we told the macro to do. I'm sure you found this useful. Thanks for watching.